products and machinery, we learn about capillarity. So let's start the class. What is capillarity? Capillarity is a consequence of surface tension. Capillarity, also known as capillary effect, it is the rise or fall of liquid in a small diameter tube inserted into the liquid. Such narrow tubes or confined flow channels are called capillaries. Suppose we put a small diameter tube into a liquid. So we can see there is a rise or fall of liquid inside the tube. This phenomena is known as capillary effect or capillarity. What are the practical examples? The rise of kerosene through a cotton wick inserted into the reservoir of a kerosene lamp is due to this effect. The capillary effect is also partially responsible for the rise of water to the top of tall trees. Before going in details of capillarity, we have to understand about wetting liquids and non-wetting liquids. So let's start the wetting liquids. When a liquid possesses relatively greater affinity for solid molecules, or the liquid which have greater adhesion than cohesion, then it will wet a solid surface in contact and tend to rise at the point of contact. Such liquids are called wetting liquids. In this case, the angle of contact between the liquid and the solid surface is less than 90 degrees. Example is water. So here you can see this is a wetting liquid. In case of wetting liquid, the angle of contact is less than 90 degrees, or we can also say acute angle. Here, in case of wetting liquids, the cohesion is less than adhesion, or we can say the adhesion is more than cohesion. So here, due to more adhesion, the liquid tend to wet the solid surface. So here we can see water. If we insert a glass tube which is diameter is very small and this is partially immersed in water, the water will wet the surface of the tube and it will rise in the tube to some height above the normal water surface. In this case, the water surface is concave upward, or we can say this is concave meniscus, and this is due to surface tension force. So in case of wetting liquid, there is adhesion is more than cohesion, so we can see capillary rise, and in that case the angle of contact is less than 90 degree or acute angle, and we can say this phenomena as capillary rise of water. Next, we will discuss about non-wetting liquids. In case of non-wetting liquids, the cohesion is more than adhesion, and also the angle of contact between the liquid and solid surface is more than 90 degree. So here the angle is obtuse angle. If we put a glass tube of small diameter and this is partially immersed in mercury, the mercury will not wet the surface of the tube in contact, and the level of mercury inside the tube will be depressed, or it is lower than the normal mercury level. So here we can see a fall of mercury in case of non-wetting liquids. So mercury is an example of non-wetting liquids, and this is also the surface tension force, and this is convex meniscus, or this is capillary fall or convex and downward. And in case of non-wetting liquid, we can say the angle of contact is more than 90 degree or obtuse angle. So the capillary rise is due to adhesion and capillary fall is due to cohesion, because we have seen that in case of water, due to more adhesion, the capillary rise will occur, or rise in water column will occur, and in case of capillary fall, there is more cohesion. So the capillarity is due to adhesion and cohesion both. Let's derive an expression for capillary rise. So here we assume this is capillary water? And in the container, there is water and we put or we partially immerse the glass tube of diameter D into the water. And we can see a rise of small edge of the water or the liquid. So, the weight of the rising fluid in the tube equals to specific weight into volume of the rising fluid. We know specific weight equals to rho into g, and volume of rising fluid is pi by 4 into d square into h, where rho is the density of liquid, g is acceleration due to gravity, d is diameter of the tube, h is capillary rise, and theta is angle of contact. Now, the vertical component of surface tension force will be sigma into pi into d into cos theta. So, for equilibrium, the vertical component of surface tension force will be equal to weight of the rising fluid. So, here we put sigma into pi into d cos theta equals to rho into g into pi by 4 d square h. So, h is 4 sigma cos theta by rho g d. So, this is the expression for capillary rise. Here, we take the capillary rise of water. It can be observed that the capillary rise is inversely proportional to the diameter of the tube, because h is inversely proportional to d. And the same equation can be used to calculate the capillary depression, which is for mercury. In such cases, the theta will be obtuse and h should be negative. Why negative? Because there will be capillary fall. The expression will be same. Only you have to put negative sign in front of this equation. So, in that case, the equation will be h equals to minus 4 sigma cos theta by rho g t. That's all for today's class. If you have any doubt, please feel free to ask me anything. If you like the video, please share with your friends. For more updates, subscribe my channel and don't forget to press the bell icon. Thanks for watching.